फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू मैट्रिक्स मैथ्स चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स। वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इट दैट देर आर टू मेथड्स फॉर सॉल्विंग लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स, दैट आर ग्राफिकल मेथड एंड एल्जेब्रिक मेथड। First, let us discuss how to solve a linear equation two variables through graphical method. In case of graph also, there are three types of graph. We already know that there are three types of solution. That is, a solutions with, that is consistent solutions with unique solution, an equation with consistent with infinitely many solution, and inconsistent with no solution. So in our graph also there are three types of graph which represent three types of solution. For that, let's discuss this. Let the system of pair of linear equation be a1x plus b1y equal to c1 and a2x plus b2y equal to c2. These are the two pair of linear equation. First case. What is the first case? Here the case will be the two lines will intersect at one point. Here when we draw a graphs of a linear equation, then we get a graph where here L11 represent one equation and L2 represent another equation. When we solve this equation graph, then that equation, that line, what happened to the line? The lines will be intersecting at a point. Then this intersection point, this point of intersection, it will have a unique solution. This is a graph with the unique solution, consistence with unique solution. And what will be the value of x and y? That value of x and y will be alpha and beta. This is a one type of graph. That is, the two lines will intersect at one point. At that point, we will get the solutions for the linear equation. Second case is that the two lines will not intersect. However, for they are extended, that is, they are parallel. They will not be intersecting. That is, when the two pairs, that is, two equations, when we solve through graphically, then that equation, that lines that will not be intersecting, that two lines will seems to be parallel. Then, if such cases arise, what we can define? That then such equation is inconsistent with no solution. Then we have no solution for this, because what here there won't be any intersection point or no coincidences, so it will have no solution. So if such graph, that is this type of a graph is given, then we can clearly define that this graph, this solution or this equation has no solution. Then there are next third type of equation, that is third type of case or the graph. What is that? That two lines are coincident lines. That is means what? Here, when we equate the lines, then we get a coincident line. That is L1 and L2. That will be same. Then if such condition is existed, then we can define this equation as consistent with many, infinitely many solution. These are the three types of solutions for the graph. Now let's verify our answers through our questions. I will give you a questions. Draw the graph of the following linear equations. What are the linear equation we got? That is 3x plus y equal to 5, 2x minus y equal to 5. Then first of all, what are the working rules? First of all, we have to make one value for this, that is 3x plus y equal to 5. Here y means what? Here y equal to 5 minus 3x. Here what we have done, we have taken this one, here this one is taken. So what is the reverse? What is this function changes? Here is plus, so when we take the two RHS side, its sine function changes to minus. So y is equal to 5 minus 3x. Now we can give the value. When x is equal to 0, when what will be the value of y? Value of y will be 5 minus 3 into 0. What is that? 5 minus 0 is equal to 5. Then, when value of x is equal to 1, what will be the value of y? When x is equal to 1, value of y will be 5 minus 3 into 1 means 3. So 5 minus 3, that's equal to 2. Then what will be the value of x when it is given as y is equal to 0? When y is equal to 0, what is the value of when then 3x is equal to 5 and x is equal to 5 by 3? Then what is that value? 5 by 3 is equal to 1.25. 1.25 we can round it as 1.3. Then what is the second pair of linear equation? That is 2x minus y equal to 5. Then 2x is equal to y plus 5. And x is equal to 5 plus y by 2. Then what will be the case when x is equal to 0? When x is equal to 0, y will be minus 5. Then when x is equal to 3, here it is, here x also can find, y also value can. 2x minus y is equal to 5. Here not only x, we can find the value of y also, okay? Y equal, if we write y equal to 2x minus 5. Here, when we given value of x is equal to 0, what will be the value of y? Value of y equal to minus 5. Then when we given x is equal to 3, what will be the value of 5? Y will be 2 into 3, my is equal to 6. 6 minus 5, that's equal to 1. Then what will be the value of y when we give the value of x as 4? 2 into 4 is equal to 8. 8 minus 5, 3. Okay, here we got the values for this one, x and y. Now let's look how we draw this graph. That we have to draw a like this one, Cartesian, that is x-axis and y-axis. Here we have minus 5 point and minus value. So I have drawn the negative for the x and also for the y. Here, first, what we have got the value for x? Here we have marked x is equal to 0 and y equal to 5. What is the next value? Next value is when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. This also we have to mark in our graph. Where we have to mark, that is x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. Here we have to mark, that is 1 and 2. Then what is the next value we have given? Next value is, what is the next value? Here 1.3 and y equal to 0. So mark this value in our graph. We have marked our third value also, that is 1.3 and 0. Next, what we have to do? We have to draw a line regarding these points through this point. This is the line that represent 3x plus y equal to 5. Next word, next we have another line. Which is the line? I will show you. What are the values of the lines? I will show you that. Next is the equation 2x minus y equal to 5. Here, when x is equal to 3, y value is equal to 1. So we have to mark the same value in our graph. X equal to 3 and y is equal to 1. When x is equal to 3, y is equal to 1. So just look at there, okay. 3 and 1. Next, what is that? When x is equal to 4, we got the value y is equal to 3. Again, mark that point. X is equal to 4 and y equal to 3. Then last value, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 5. So what you have to do? We have to join these points. This is the line which represent 2x minus y equal to 5. Here, where is that? Here we got a intersection point. Which is that intersection point? Here we got a point of intersection. If the graph shows a point of intersection, means what? It is a consistent equation with unique solution. Just look at the where is the point of intersection. That is, that value is x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1.5. This is the value. So what is that? Here, when we find the solutions for this value, that is 3x plus y is equal to 5, 2x minus y is equal to 5, then what do we got the value? Here we got x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1.5. This is the solution for this graph. Next question, that is 4x plus 5y equal to 9, 8x plus 10y is equal to 18. Before going on to this video, please pause for a minute and try to do this problem by yourselves. After that, continue the video and verify your answers whether you have got the correct graph or not. So first, what you have to do? We have to rewrite this question. That is 4x plus 5y equal to 9. 4x plus 5y equal to 9. Here, what is the second question? That is, next second question is 8x plus 10y is equal to 18. When we divide these by 4, what you will get? When we divide these by 2, that is divided by 2, 8x will be changes to 4x and 10y will be changes to 5 and 18 will be changes to 9. What you got? You got 2 as 2 equation as same equation. So whenever we are seeing this type itself, we can understand, we will be clear about that. The graph will be constants, because what? When we get every solutions as like this, what will be here? Same solution is there. That is means what? You will be coincident. That is, you will be having many solutions. There won't be any intersection. So for our verifications and for our graphs, let's do our problem. Here, what is that? 4x is equal to 9 minus 5y and x is equal to 9 minus 5y by 4. Here, when value of y is equal to 0, what will be the value of 9? That is 9 minus 5. 9 minus 5 will, that means what? 9 minus 5 into 0, 9 by 4. That will be 2.25. Then when, what is the value of x, when will be the value of y is equal to 1? That is 4 by 4 is equal to 1. So let's, we can do this by our graph. For drawing the graph, let me show this one. Here I didn't got any negative value, so I have drawn only positive axis of the x and positive axis of this y. Here first, what do you have got? We got the value of x is equal to 2.25 when the value of y is equal to 0. So mark that point, 2.250. Then what do you got? The another value, that is x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. That's so. So what is this? Then we have to, what that, after that we have to join these two points. Here both equations line segment, what is that? Both equations line segment, that is L1 and L2, is same for this. So what is this? So here good, we got the only one line segment representing the graph, because what? Two equations are same. So it is, that means what? It is a coincidence line. So it has the equation, given equation is consistent with infinitely many solution. We cannot find which is exact solution for the given variable, so it has many solution. So this is one of the kind of the graph, right? So let's move on to the third problem. What is the third question? That is 2x plus 3y is equal to 15, 4x plus 6y is equal to 24. First, what you have to do? Rewrite this one. 2x plus 3y is equal to 15. 2x, well, for that, make a column, x and y. Here, when x is equal to 0, what will be the value of y? When x is equal to 0 means 2 into 0 is equal to 0. Then 3y is equal to 15. Then y equal to 15 by 3 means what is the answer? 5. Then when y equal to 0, what is the value of 2? When y is equal to 0, 3 into 0. 2x plus 3 into 0 equal to 15. 2x plus 0 is equal to 15 and x is equal to 15 by 2. That means it is equal to 7.5. Here, what is the next equation given for x plus 6y is equal to 24? Here, every number, that is coefficient of x, coefficient of y and 24, that's constant number, has common 2. So, divide both this one, this whole equation by which number? 2. Then what we get? We get 2x plus 3y equal to 12. Again, you make a columns x, y. Here, when x is equal to 0, what is the value, what will be the value of y? When x is equal to 0, value of y will be 4. Then when y is equal to 0, what will be the value of x? When y is equal to 0, 2x plus 3 into 0 means, here's your 2x plus equal to 12. Then 2x is equal to 12. Then x is equal to 6. Here we got the two boxes. Then what do you have to do? We have to draw a graph. Let's do the graph. So first, what we have got, we have to draw this one, graphs. That is x-axis and y-axis. Now, just look. What is the first equation's value? When x is equal to that and y is equal to here. When x is equal to 0, we got the value y is equal to 5. So mark that point and also please note that one. When x is equal to 7.5, we got y is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, what is the value of y? When x is equal to 0, value of y is equal to 5. 0, 5. Then when y is equal to 0, what is the value of x? That is 7.5. Mark that point also. Then what you have to do? We have to join the points. Only 2 points is enough for our joining, okay? We don't want to find, we don't waste the time by finding a large values. So what is that? X is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. That's enough. Put the value x0 and y0. So it will be easy for our calculation. So this is the equation. This is the line for the first equation. Which equation? Equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 3y equal to 15. What is the next question we got? Next question is 2x plus 3y is equal to 12. What are the values when x is equal to 0, y equal to 4. When x is equal to 6, y is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to what is the value? That value is 4, 0, 4. Then, when y is equal to 0, what is the value of x? That is 6, 6, 0. Now, what you have to do? Join the two points. Now, which type of graph we got? Which type of graph we got? We got a parallel graph. Graph with parallel lines. So, which type of equation will be that? It will be inconsistent with no solution. This equation has no solution because what? It has no intersection point, no coincidence. So, this graph has no solution. So, we have done three problems with three types of graphs, that is intersecting graph, coincidence graph and parallel graph. So what is the condition? If intersecting lines means it is consistent with unique solution and coincidence lines means consistent with infinitely many solution and parallel lines means inconsistent with no solution. We have done three graph also. I hope you have enjoyed this graph and this sections. If you have any doubt regarding these graphical method, you can comment on the comment box and clarify your doubts. I hope you have enjoyed a lot in learning this chapter, that is graphical method to solve linear equation in two variables. If yes, please thumbs up to my channel and share it with your friends and relatives. If you haven't so far subscribed my channel, kindly subscribe my channel and support. Thank you.